All right, so fellas, I just got a couple questions for you. 55, you're captain. Tomorrow, what are you going to do to lead the defense? 5, when adversity strikes on defense, how are you going to step up and lead these guys? 15, tomorrow, how are you going to come out and get these guys ready for tomorrow? 57, I know you love to talk. Okay, so tomorrow, how are you going to get the O-line ready? How are you going to lead them? So we obviously have a couple leaders on both sides of the ball. Sounds like to me they're trying to lead more by example. So you guys need to follow their example, right? I found this video online last year, and it's kind of like a coincidence that I got a top during this week. Last year, we were 0-2 against this team, right? Okay? It's a new year.
Listen to me, I started studying the greats. And what I realized about the greats, y'all, is that the greats is not about talent.
So, my question to you is, what are you going to do right now to get ready for tomorrow? As Coach always says, every rep, every step, you got to pretend that's the state championship. What are you going to do right now to prepare yourself for one of your hardest battles you'll face all year?
Now, we saw a video of last year. Well, this is two totally different teams. They lost most of their seniors. We lost most of their seniors. But in essence, it's still the two same programs, okay? It's basically the same things, the same entities going against each other. They haven't changed. We haven't changed. They work hard, they bust their butt in the weight room, and that's what we do. So it's an extension of what happened last year. They ought to be proud how well they're playing. They're gonna complete passes. They're gonna make plays. They're a good team. They're a great team, okay? We've gotta make more. I don't care if somebody says, hey, you guys look cocky or that, whatever. I just want somebody to say, hey, that team plays hard every single play.
Tomorrow night's homecoming, it's a big night. All the distractions of the week, it's built around one thing. I ain't having homecoming during basketball season. I ain't having homecoming for a Thursday night soccer. It's built around football.
Good evening and welcome to St. Thomas Aquinas High School in Overland Park, Kansas. We have a top 5 Class 5A matchup for you this evening between the Saints of Aquinas, who are hosting the Class 5A defending state champion Mill Valley Jaguars. It should be a good one. This is homecoming for Aquinas, so the stands here at the stadium are packed.
Look, if you had one shot.
Swanson keeps it, breaks across midfield, has a first down. Pitch to Davis, off left end, inside the 40. Davis puts his head down, gets near the 30-yard line. Complete to the receiver, Grant Cowley. And Swanson will dive forward, has the first down. Throws, crossing route, caught inside the 5 for the first down. Handoff, Jackson, off left end, touchdown Saints. That ball tipped up in the air, nearly intercepted, they say incomplete. Breaks the tackle, has a lane, smashing forward for a first down, still on his feet, down the sideline. Will Swanson. Fair catches and he drops the ball. Ball is loose and it's still rolling around into the end zone. There's a pile in the end zone. Who has it? St. Thomas Aquinas touchdown Saints. It's picked up by Sam Wolf, the junior. He's brought down short of the line of scrimmage by Ryan Jerzak. Turning upfield is Morrissey. Here's a handoff to Young, who gets smacked to the line of scrimmage. Pushback by Ryan Jerzak. Flaming to throw, looking over the middle. Intercepted! Intercepted by Aquinas. Jared Flood running up the far side of the field, and he's taken down short of midfield. Javier Derrett leading the charge. That's a no-gainer. Hands off again to Young. Gets short yardage, and now the ball's on the ground again. St. Thomas Aquinas says they have it, and they do. Smashes through, touchdown Aquinas. It's the freshman, Matthew Roberts. Swanson in trouble, rolling left. Lost the pass for the two-point conversion, caught by Joseph Clune. Flush to his right, throws from his back heel in the air. Intercepted by Aquinas. Intercepted and brought back by Ryan Jerzak. He's got a block. He's inside the 15 and all the way down near the Mill Valley 10. Swanson keeps around left end, diving for the end zone. He is in. Touchdown, Saints. In the backfield and taken down. Breaks free, nearly broken all the way to the end zone. Counter play. It's Tristan Davis up the near sideline into Mill Valley territory for a first down on a big gainer. Bully with the reception. He has time in the pocket, throwing down the field into the end zone. It's Clue! Touchdown! St. Thomas Aquinas! The team known for the flex bone running goes ahead with a 36-yard pass to the tight end, Joseph Clune. Snap is down, kick is up, and it is good. 40-33, St. Thomas Aquinas. Flaming, holding to his right, throwing to the end zone to try to tie it into a crowd. Knocked down, incomplete. I don't think they bronze, only know how to be one way, that's the dog. I know. One last shot, an untimed down from the 14 into the end zone. It's too long, incomplete again, and Aquinas holds on. Final score from St. Thomas Aquinas. Saints 40, Jags 33.